Hi, welcome to our fifth Qt tutorial. Today we are going to explain the code behind Hello World app from our last tutorial. So if you haven't seen my last video, now is great time to watch it. Look for the link in descriptions below this video. If you don't see the link, click on show more button. Let's get started. Run Qt Creator. In our last video, we have created simple Hello World project. Now we have to open that project. In Qt Creator, under Welcome mode, you can use Open Project button. Alternatively, you can go to File, Open File or Project. Also, we have recently edited projects. Here, we can choose Hello World app that we created in last video. Just double click on it and the project will open. We are automatically switched to edit mode. On the left, you can see the sidebar. Here, we can see our project and files associated to it. First file on top of the list is Hello World Pro. This is our project file. Project file contains all the information required to build your application. Let's take a look inside. Double click on the file. Green lines that start with hashcode are comments. We are not going to explain the whole file here. If you want to know more about the project file, find the link under the title Learn More About Project File in description below this video. Symbian Target Capability Network Services enables our application to make phone calls, send emails, MMS, SMS, and to use IP protocols. Since this is simple Hello World app, it doesn't need these things. We are going to comment out this line. If you want to learn more about capabilities, go to link under the title Learn More About Capabilities in description below this video. So let's comment out this line. The config here is a variable. It specifies options and features that we are going to use in our application. If you remember, when we created the app, in our last video, we specified we wanted to use Qt components. That's why Qt components is added to our config variable. In the sources variable, you must add source code files that you wish to use when building the project. Main.cpp was added automatically for us. Speaking of which, let's take a look at the main.cpp file. Let's open sources folder and double click on main.cpp file. This is C++ file. C++ code is referred to as native code in the documentation. The code here initializes the runtime. The QApplication class manages the graphic user interface application's control flow and main settings. One application should have only one QApplication object. QmlApplicationViewer is our QML runtime. Its main purpose is to load QML documents and to execute them. So basically, main.cpp file sets up the application runtime. Afterwards, it loads the QML file and afterwards it shows it to you. Maybe you have noticed tooltips that show when I pause my pointer on the code. If I pause my mouse on QApplication, it will get the short explanation about the class. I can also hit F1 for additional help. You can see that we are currently in help mode. Here we can check out detailed description on the QApplication class. When you are done, return to the edit mode. You will notice QmlApplicationViewer does not have additional explanations. This is because it's not part of the framework. You can see the source code of the class in QmlApplicationViewer directory. When you open its header file, you can read more about it. So this file is generated by Qt Quick Application Wizard for QtCreator. It's a convenience class containing mobile device specific code, such as screen orientation handling. It is recommended not to modify this file, since newer version of Qt Creator may offer an update version of this file. we can simply close the header file by clicking on the X. In this tutorial, we have covered our native C++ code and also our project file. In our next tutorial, we will continue exploring the code behind Hello World app. We will cover QML files. They are also referred to as declarative code. If you like my tutorials, please subscribe or like the video. By doing this, you are giving me feedback on my videos and I will make more of them. If you don't like them, write me a comment saying which part you don't like and why. I will try to make videos better. Next video is coming soon. Subscribe and make sure you don't miss it.